Well, I'm out here. Oh, probably to get away from the wife, really. just enjoy sailing. Nice day for it. And, yeah, it's great.
Just for a bit of a race on a Sunday. And hopefully go and beat them all. It's a nice day for it.
Well, today Howick Sailing Club has the Sir William Goddard William Memorial race, which is traditionally a Mark Foy start, which means that everybody starts on their handicap at different times. So that's why there's a few boats still left on the beach and quite a few boats out on the water, possibly already coming up for their start. Well, I'm not sure how many boats we've got today, but it would probably be around 20 or 30 boats. Something in that order. Yeah. We have quite a good fleet of optimists. There's about a dozen optimists. They're the young junior class, and they're very keen, and that class is growing almost every week. And the other senior classes are mostly pretty much stalwarts. Been sailing for years, and we've got a few newcomers jumped into sunbursts for their first season, and we've got a couple of guys here that are now in their second or third season in catamaran, so they used to be new to the game, but they've actually caught on really quickly. The weather's quite interesting because at the moment it's coming from the west or slightly north of west, and it's forecast to go around to the southwest and build up to maybe 20 knots, which could be pretty entertaining. So most yachtsmen quite like a bit of a breeze, so looking forward to that. We've got a normal racing every Sunday, and it varies between morning and afternoon according to the tide. And we've got our 3.7 Auckland Championships. This is a 3.7 I'm sailing in March, and at the same time over that weekend we've got the Howick Open Champs. So anybody that wants to come is welcome. Yeah, so that's an open championship for definitely for lasers and sunbursts and optimists, and any other class that wants to join in, we'd be happy to accommodate them.
Well, the first boat in was Les Gallagher in a 3.7, yeah. And the second was Rex McCamish in a laser. And then came Mark Gallagher, Les's son, in a sunburst. Then Trent Cornwall in a 3.7. And fifth then was the Commodore, Jon Brett, in a 3.7.
I just went out there for a sail, really. And it just sort of come together.
Yeah. Oh, disappointing. Yeah, a bit of gear failure. Too far behind from the rest of them to start.
That's a hard week.
Thank you. They're all meant to cross the first line together. Here.
Hanging up on the hooks here.
You're going to start the clock? The clock start? You've been over.
Huh?
You've been over.
Oh.
going to go in, are you?
I've got 46 up here. They're out there, but they'll be just going around the red mark, back to the blue.
Oh, that would be good.
Up here, out there.
Oh, that's it, yeah, that's right.
Just tell them to come around us.
Yeah. Sorry about moving the mark, Andrew. Who's it going to be? It's going to be close. Les is right there. If you want to, yeah. You can go straight in if you like. Yep.
First bait in was Les Gallagher and a 3.7, and the second was Rex McCamish and a laser, and then came Mark Gallagher, Les's son, and a sunburst, then Trent Cornwall in a 3.7, and fifth in was the Commodore, Jon Brett, in a 3.7.
Excellent.
Yeah, so tell us about the winning strategy. Tell me about how you raced the race.
Well, No, yeah. It just went out there for a sail, really. And it just sort of come together. Yeah, which I was very pleased with.
Okay.
Yeah.
So tell us a bit about the conditions out there.
Oh, it was very changeable. 1 minute, yeah, it's blowing quite hard. Then the next minute, there's hardly any wind at all. And the wind was changing direction quite a bit. So luckily, I was able to hang on there. Yeah.
Excellent.